We are a vendor for software and hardware. Actually, it depends a little bit on the case whether our technology goes into software or hardware. We call it biologically inspired intelligence. That's the focus we have. And the you know, it's quite accepted that semantic technologies will be very important in the future. Web 2.0, 3.0, and all the community platforms and everything. And we have heard a lot of speeches already that profiling and, you know, customer behavior and everything is very, very important. Still, the way how we try to achieve that, that's not a new one. I mean, we have tried that for many years, 20 years ago, 50 years ago, first ideas came up how artificial intelligence could work. So knowledge management, artificial intelligence, everything. But so far, it didn't enter the mass markets for certain reasons. One reason is that the expected quality and the expected intelligence in those solutions didn't happen. Now, most reason is that in all the different branches, in all the different applications, you had to use so many different algorithms and solutions to get there. So if you were in imaging, okay, you had to have a solution for imaging. If you were in text or language, you have to use a solution for text and language. So that didn't work really as we expected. And one of the reasons why it didn't work was we concentrated on logic only. We tried that, you know, with logic, we can solve that problem. It's pure mathematics, analytics. And now, no wonder if you compare how humans function, they not only logic, there's a lot of emotion, there is a lot of fantasy and stuff in there. So no wonder that this artificial intelligence didn't fit, because there was a missing part of it. It was missing 50% actually, because, you know, we are working with two sides of the brain and not only with one side of the brain. So the simple solution to that is, well, okay, we add on the other half of the brain. So we add on this creative side, we add on the pattern recognition, but not analytically viewing, differently viewing, you know, as a solution which goes very, very similar like the human brain. So if we can combine the two into one platform, then we will achieve the quality and the results the way as we would expect them. And that's exactly what we offer with biologically inspired intelligence. So we call it biological inspired because it's not artificially. That means it looks like a rose, it smells like a rose, but it's not really one. We say, if you like to have a replacement in a certain workflow with the same intelligence as a human would be there, well, then you have to allow the system to be trained by the human in a very easily way. So that's why we say biological inspired. So you inspire the intelligence the machine has to use. So then the machine is enabled to have the same decisions made as you would have been there and as you would have made these decisions. So that's why we have to have the two better brain halves. So we have the creative side and we have the logical side. Now, if you're interested in getting enabled to do that, and that's what we are selling, we're selling a piece of 500 kilobyte which enables you to do that. So if you are a software vendor, hardware vendor, whatever you do, you're going to get this 500 kilobyte into your workflow, and that will enable you to treat semantic in text or language, image recognition in movies or images, whatever you have. And it's the same 500 kilobyte, by the way. The same library, the same API will enable you to treat pixel, vectors, whatever you have. So that's really the revolution, because so far we needed to have all these different mathematics solutions and ideas and concepts and the single approaches to all those different kind of data. Now we can combine it. And that's again very similar that humans do it. I mean, humans have one brain, so all the information is in one brain. Well, they're using two halves to treat the information, and that's what we're trying to do now, so that we learn and teach the computer how to use the creativity side, how to use the analytics, logical side, to come to the same conclusions and analytics like a human would do in a certain data area. Now, so we are selling a kind of a library, API, a kind of a language, and then you manufacturing on top whatever you have as a application, solution, workflow, whatever you have. Now, you can imagine that this kind of technology will be suitable for many, many different verticals. So biometrics, forensics, semantical technologies. So it's almost unlimited where this technology can go in. And since the library and the core technology is only 500 kilobytes, you can pack it into an FPGA, you can pack it into an ASIC. It depends the solution you're looking for. You rather spend the money for doing a little bit of research to get it into hardware, or you take it as a software solution. So I don't know in which areas your companies are located, but we found that in almost every branch, there is a need for more intelligence in the processes, or more intelligence in the search functionality, in the matching functionality, whatever you have. So that's what we offer to the market. We originally are Zurich-based in Switzerland. We came here because we had this returning stuff in Berlin, and then we have been invited by Alex last spring to visit the North American Congress. And so when we were here and we had a speech here too, the interest was so heavy that we decided during the conference to change our headquarters from Zurich to America. So we started the company here in America, and by now all the shareholders are transferred into the US company, and the Zurich formerly headquarters turned into a research lab, and the headquarters now is here in the United States in San Diego. So Red Herring influenced our you know workflow tremendously, and the interest in the market, I mean, as you know, if you have IT technology, information technology, California is a very nice place to start things because acceptance is very high. You can launch new ideas and new concepts very easily, where in other areas in this world, you know, they take a little bit longer. So that's the reason why we're here. We're very happy that we have been appointed by Red Herring at that time, and that they, created that turbo into our company. And if there are any questions, I'm hanging around here so we can have some discussions. If you need more intelligence in your applications, then just tell us. We may be able to help you. Thank you.